Hello everyone. Welcome to the series of lectures on the course Foundations of Mathematics. In this session, we will learn how to construct a bijection between two intervals. Alright, so the general idea is if I have two intervals, let's say closed intervals AB and CD, then how do I construct a function f from AB to CD, from this first interval to the second interval, which is a bijection? Alright, so before moving on to the general case, I will start with some particular intervals, and from that we will try to build up a bijection from any arbitrary closed interval to any other given closed interval. Alright, so first, supposing I have the interval closed interval 0, 1, and let's say I have the interval 0, 5. Okay, and I want to find a function from 0, 1 to 0, 5, which is a bijection. Alright, so you can think of that as this. 0 is here, 1 is here, and let's say 5 is here. So let me put this 0, 1 in red. Okay, so that's 0, 1, and I have 0, 5. So what you can do is you can think of this 0 as one point and 1 as one point here, and this red line that I have drawn is a rubber. Let's say a rubber, okay, which is tied at 0 and 1, a stretchable rubber, okay. And what I do is from here, I will stretch it from 1 and I will take it to 5, okay. So the rubber, I am fixing it at 0, one end is fixed at 0. Now what I will do is from 1, I will stretch it and I will take it to 5. So what is going to happen is the rubber will expand this way and it will come up to 5, and the point 1 is here, right? So what we are actually doing is to each point from 0 to 1 here, we are multiplying 5, and that's how I will get this interval 0, 5, all the points in this interval 0, 5, right? So this gives us the idea that I can define a map from closed interval 0, 1 to closed interval 0, 5 by any point x. If you take in closed interval 0, 1, you map it to 5x. Alright, and it's, so I can define a map f from closed 0, 1 to closed 0, 5 by f of x is equal to 5x for each x in 0, right? So it can be easily seen that this function is a bijective function. So clearly f is bijection, alright? So you can check this for yourself. It shouldn't be difficult to check that this map that we have defined is a bijection. Okay, so closed interval 0, 1 and the closed interval 0, 5, these two are bijective. When do you say that two sets are bijective? When you can find a bijective function from one set to the other set, right? So I can extend this idea, and I can find a bijection from closed interval 0, 1 to any interval of the form 0, comma, let's say P now. And how I can define this map if? Define this map by f of x is equal to px for each x in 0, 1. Right? So that's a bijection that we are looking out for. So this is a general case. So if you have 0, 1 closed interval to 0, p, where p is any positive real number, then I can define a bijection between them. So 0, 1 and 0, p, these two intervals are bijective. Alright. Now, let's go one step higher. Supposing I have the closed interval 0, 1 with me, and I have one more interval, let's say 9 comma 10. Okay, and I want to exhibit a bijection between these two intervals. What I can do here is, let's say I have this interval 0, 1, and I have 0, 9 with me. Sorry, 9, 10 with me. Alright. So what I can do is, I can simply translate this, the points here, 0, 1, this closed interval by the number 9. So it's like the string which was there from 0 to 1, it was tied from 0 to 1. That string, what I can do is, I can just translate it by 9. So where that string will come if I translate that by 9? The string which is here between 0 and 1, okay, I'm moving it by 9 units. So it will come here, right? So what I'm doing, every point in this interval, I'm translating or I'm shifting it towards my right by 9 units. Okay, so if I take any point x here, I'm changing it to 9 plus x. And this defines a bijection from these two intervals. Okay, so I can define a map G from 0, 1 to 9, 10 by G of any point x is x plus 9 or 9 plus x for all x in 0. Then it can be easily seen that G is a bijection. Okay, that's a trivial computation. Then G is a bijection. Alright, so you can verify this for yourself that G is a bijection. Okay, next we will see how to construct a bijection between closed interval 0, 1 and let's say any interval 9, 14. Okay, so based on the last two examples that I took, I've picked up this interval 9, 14. You can pick this to be any interval a comma b, okay, provided a is less than b, so that this interval contains some points and it is non-empty. Okay, so if you look at the last two constructions that we did, in the first case we multiplied each point in the interval 0, 1 by 5, right, to get a bijection between 0, 1 to 0, 5, and then to get a bijection between 0, 1 to 9, 10, we just translated each and every point in 0, 1 by 9 to get a bijection between these two. Right? So, both these processes now we are going to combine to get a bijection between 0, 1 and this interval 9, 4. Alright? So, I have the closed interval 0, 1 and I have the interval 9, 4. So, what we will do is, we will use the first construction that we saw. That is, to each and every point in this interval 0, 1, we will multiply these numbers by the number 5. That's the difference between these two. Okay. So, that will give me the points from this interval 0 to 5. Now what I can do, each and every point in this, now if I translate by 9 of the interval 0, 5, okay, so from here to here I am multiplying it by 5, so I have this map, right, and then I am translating each and every point from 0, 5 by 9. Right? So 0 will be translated to 9 and 5 will be translated to 14, and each and every point in between 0 and 5 will be translated to points between 9 and 14. Right? So what I can do now, I can define a map, let's say H from 0, 1 to 9, 14 by H of any point here, I will map it to 5x plus 9. Okay, so this 5 is nothing but the difference between these two. 14 minus 5 is 9 is. Alright, so the, you can easily check that H is a bijection. Shouldn't be difficult to check that H is a bijection. Okay, so you can check this for yourself that H is a bijection. So, in general now, how do I generalize this? So, in general, I can define a map F from closed interval 0, 1 to any closed interval AB. Here I am assuming that A is less than B. Okay, so that this is a non-empty set. So what I can do, how I can find a bijection between closed interval 0, 1 to closed interval AB? So first what we will do is, given any point X here, we will multiply that by the difference of these two numbers b and a. Okay, and then I will translate each and every point by a. That means I will add a, and that is the required bijection. So I can define this map by f of any point x will be b minus a times x plus the point a. This will hold for all x in. Fine. So that's the required bijection between 0, 1, closed interval 0, 1 and any closed interval AB, provided A is less than B. So you can check for yourself that then F is a bijection. Alright, so again I will leave this as an exercise. F is a bijection. You can check this for yourself. We have already seen how to check whether a function is bijective or not. So you can try this. So finally, what we have shown is closed interval 0, 1 is bijective with any other closed interval AB provided A is less than. Alright. Now, this is a bijection. Okay. So every bijective function, if I take, it will have an inverse. And the inverse will be a map from closed interval AB to closed interval 0, 1. And we have already seen that the inverse, if it exists, is also a bijection. Right? That means I can find a bijection from any closed interval AB to closed interval 0, 1. Right? So next what we will do is, we will reverse the process of F and we will find the inverse. So how do I reverse this process? Let me do that as a rough work here. Let's pick up one point in A comma B. Okay, let me call it Y. Then I want to find X in 0, 1 such that F of X is equal to Y. Right, f of x will be equal to y if and only if, what is f of x? That's b minus a times x plus a, if this is equal to y. And that will happen if and only if x is equal to y minus a by b minus a. Okay, and you can easily check that this number will be inside 0. Right, so I can define one more map. Let me call it, let's say some other notation, G say. So define G from A comma B to 0 1 by G of any point x you take here, okay, that will be x minus a upon b minus for all x in a. Alright, so this is nothing but the inverse of this function f that we defined from closed interval 0, 1 to closed interval a, b. Right, so then g is nothing but the inverse of f. And hence is also a bijection. So we have found bijections from closed interval 0, 1 to closed interval AB and from closed interval AB to closed interval 0. Okay, so now we are going to combine both these ideas to construct a bijection between any two arbitrary closed interval, between let's say AB and CD. Okay, so this is the general case that I was talking about in the beginning. So what we are going to do is we are going to use the idea of composition of functions. Now between A and B and 0 and 1, this interval, I can find a bijection. That's what we saw just now, right? And again, from 0, 1 to CD, I can also find a bijection. This also we saw just now. So if I find a bijection G from AB to 0, 1, closed intervals, and a bijection from closed interval 0, 1 to CD, let me call it F, then composition of these two functions will be the function from AB to CD closed intervals, right? And that will be the map F composite G, which will be a bijection from closed interval AB to closed interval C. Okay, so this is the idea behind the constructing bijection between these two intervals, closed interval AB and closed interval C. Alright, so let's do it formally. So I will define a map G from closed interval AB to closed interval 0, 1 by, we have already seen this here. So this is that required map. Okay, G of x equal to x minus a by b minus. So this is defined by g of x is equal to x minus a by b minus a, which is a bijection. Okay, we have just agreed that this g is a bijection. And again, I can find a map f from closed interval 0, 1 to closed interval CD by, now if you go back and check, we have a bijection from closed interval 0, 1 to closed interval AB. So instead of AB now, I have CD closed interval. Okay, so X will be mapped to D minus C times X plus C. Okay, so I will replace those notations by a new notations. So F of any point X will be D minus C times X plus, I will translate it by C. Okay, so we have already seen that. Then F and G are both bijections . Now I can talk about G composite F, right? Because the codomain of G is closed interval 0, 1, and that is exactly the domain of F. So I can talk about F composite G. Then F composite G is a map defined from closed interval AB to closed interval CD. And how will this map be defined? So this will be defined as F composite G of X, which is F of G of X. But what is G of X? That's F of X minus A by B minus A. And what is F of any point X? That's D minus C into X plus C. Right, so this will be, this is like your X now, so that will be X minus A upon B minus A into this number D minus C, right, plus this number C. And because F and G are bijections, composition of two bijections is also a bijection. This result we have already seen. Okay, so since F and G are bijections, F composite G is also a bijection. Right? So, what we have done is, given any two intervals now, closed interval AB and closed interval CD, we have constructed a bijection between. Okay, and that is given by this map. So let me put that in red. So this is that map which I'm talking. Okay, from any arbitrary closed interval AB to any arbitrary closed interval C. So our conclusion is that any two closed intervals if I pick up, okay, any two closed intervals if I take, then they are bijective. That means I can produce a bijection between them. Okay. And when I'm talking about the closed interval CD, I'm assuming that C is strictly less than D. Okay. And again here, A is strictly less than D. Okay. So these are the assumptions that I'm making. All right. So any two closed intervals are bijective to each. Next, we will construct a bijection between closed interval 0, 1 and open interval 0. Alright, so I have these two intervals. So construct to construct a bijection between these two intervals, closed interval 0, 1 and open interval 0, 1. So let me put them on the number line. So I will draw it here. I have the closed interval 0, 1. So supposing this is 0 and I have this interval 0, 1. So the endpoints are included in this interval, so that's the closed interval 0, 1, and I have the open interval 0, 1 wherein the endpoints are not included. Okay, so supposing this is 0 and 1 and an open interval 0 and 1. Then what I will do is, we need to find a bijection between these two intervals. That is, I need to define a map F from closed interval 0, 1 to open interval 0, 1, which is a bijection. Okay, so we need to define this map. So let's see how to go about this. Now from the first interval, I will look at a sequence of these points. Okay, I'll look at 0. It's a point of this interval. Yes. 1. It's a point of this interval. Then half. 1 by 3. 1 by 4. 1 by 5 and so on. Alright, I'm just picking up the sequence of points and I'll show you all how to construct a bijection between these two. Now if you try to copy the same sequence of points for this open interval, then 0 and 1 are not there. But other than 0 and 1, all the points of this sequence are there in this interval as well. That's half, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, and so on. So let me mark those points now. So the first point 0 is here, and the point 1 is here, and then I can mark half, I can mark 1 by 3, I can mark 1 by 4, and this keeps on going. And in this one, I can mark half, again 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, and this keeps on going. Right? Now see how I am mapping the points from closed interval 0, 1 to open interval 0, 1. Okay, so the first point 0 here in this sequence, I will map it to the first point here, that's half. Okay, so I will map 0 to half. Second point 1, I will map it to 1 by 3. Okay, so 1 is mapped to 1 by 3. The third point half, I'll map it to 1 by 4. So that is half is mapped to 1 by 4. Right? Then 1 by 3, the next point, I will put them in red. The next point, which is 1 by 5. And here it is also 1 by 5. So that point, 1 by 3, I will map it to 1 by 5. Okay. So 1 by 3 will go to 1 by 5, and so on. 1 by 4 will go to 1 by 6. 1 by 5 will go to 1 by 7, and so on. Okay. So these are the points of the sequence now which I have marked. But there are so many, infinitely many points between 1 and half also. For those points, I will map them to themselves. Okay, so that means if I pick up any point between half and 1 now, those points I will map them to itself. In a similar way, points between half and 1 by 3, strictly between half and 1 by 3, those points also I will map them to themselves. Okay, so can you understand what kind of how the sequence looks like? It maps 0 to half. So this function now f maps 0 to 1. It maps 1 to half. Right? And then if I take any number of the form 1 by n, then it will map it to 1 by n plus 2. Can you see this? So if I pick up f of any 1 by n, then that will map it to 1 by n plus 2. For all n greater than 1. And if I pick up any other point which is not equal to any of the points of the sequence, that is points between half and 1, points between 1 by 3 and half, points between 1 by 4 and 1 by 3, those points are mapped to themselves. So f of x is equal to x if x is not equal to 0 and it is not equal to 1 by n for all natural numbers. That means whenever x is not equal to 0, 1, half, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, and so on. Now if you see, every point in the domain has an image, right? And has only one image, so that's a function. And you can easily verify that it's a bijection. Okay, so let me formally put it down now. Before that, I made a small error here. 0 is mapped to half, not 1. Okay, and 1 is mapped to 1 by 3 and not half. Okay, other things, yeah. So 1 by 2 will be mapped to 1 by 1, 2 plus 2, that's 4. Yeah, that's correct. Okay, so that's how this function looks like. And so I can define this function now to be f of x is equal to, it will be equal to half when x is equal to 0. right? Then it will be 1 by n plus 2. This is 1. This will be 1 by n plus 2 if x is of the form 1 by n, where n is a natural number. Right? So 1 will go to 1 by 3, half will go to 1 by 4, and this keeps on going. So, and that's this is, I think I just interchanged the notations. So, f of any natural number n I will pick up. Let me keep that as x. Yeah, so this will be, yeah, okay. So, f of x will go to this, and if x is not equal to 0 or it is not equal to this, so otherwise I can map it to itself. Otherwise, x will go to itself. Okay, so if x is 1 by n, then it will map x to 1 by n plus 2. If x is 0, it will map it to half. Otherwise, it will map every point to itself. Okay, then f is a bijection. You can verify this, that f is a bijection. So we have constructed a bijection, you can check this, between closed interval 0, 1 and open interval 0. Okay, so you can generalize this and you can construct a bijection between any closed interval and any open interval. Okay, so that I'll leave it as an exercise. You all can give a try for that. These are my references. Thank you.